Hi, this is Gus Till and welcome to my studio here in Bali, and I'd like to introduce you to my new album, Ghosts of the Earth, which was created pretty well in its entirety in this room here. The album actually had its genesis back in 2006, after I'd done a track for this album, Tribal Matrix, on Dakini. And Gio from the label asked me if I could possibly do a whole album project based upon that track. So I got down to it, started writing a few tracks, but realised straight away that they were totally dissimilar to what he'd asked for, and it kind of went off in a direction of its own. And one day, a good friend of mine, Donald Baldy, turned up here. He's an Australian friend of mine living in Jakarta. And he came over to visit, and I just showed him what I was doing in the studio and asked if he wanted to pick up guitar. And we ended up writing some three or four tracks just that one afternoon. And I started developing those, and that became the basis of the album. The other featured guitarist is Steve Hillage, who should require a little introduction from his work with System 7, Mirror System, Gongs, Steve Hillage Band. He came out of the studio several times and we just worked on a few ideas here and at my friend Tim Valkenberg's studio down the road. Doing words on the opening song, We Advanced Mast, is Kamau, who lives here in Bali as well. Gave him an idea of what I kind of wanted, and he just wrote these lyrics on the spot. Fantastic job. On saxophone there's Chikarasa Motto. I met her here in Bali, she lives up in Ubud. We actually made an album together about 4 years ago, Gatalpa, which went to Norway to record. She's a fantastic talent, did some really great stuff. On percussion, Jeff Rip Van Hippie Hales, who I'd had the pleasure of playing with back in Australia. On vocals, my wife Cozzy, aka DJ Super Cozzy, who I'm half of Zen Lemonade with. She did some superlative vocals on one of the tracks, which I'll play now. Yeah, a lot of musicians from Australia appeared on the album. John Moon on guitar, Joe Crichton on bass, Simon Blinsky on bass, and my children and their friends who did some vocals. Yeah, the album's title is Ghosts of the Earth, and the idea behind the album is that no matter how much our Western monoculture runs ramshackle over things, there's still these authentic cultural voices which can't be held back. They're still there and they're still living and still breathing. If you scratch the surface, you still find these things. Even though the album's quite surreal in the processes I was trying to use, I was trying to create a kind of dreamlike state where you realise these authentic voices, whatever they were, even though it's a complete mishmash. I'm not trying to use it as a direct metaphor. It's more of a surreal imagining, some sort of weird dream world. Say in the 70s you went around to somebody's house with an LP and you'd say, look what I've got, and you'd put the LP on the stereo and you would actually sit there and listen to it. I find people don't do that anymore, but music's become an adjunct to what they're doing socially. And I wanted to do something that was the opposite to that. I wanted to do something that had edges. I wanted to have loud bits, soft bits, really raucous solos, things that were in your face. I wanted to be something that got your attention as opposed to something that was just going to hide in the background. And this is the other studio down the road from mine, which I was mentioning before. This is Tim Valkenberg's studio.
Thanks, Gus.
And this is actually the secret weapon in the arsenal. Yeah, basically, we can't get a mix right here. You'll never get a mix right anywhere.
There's something wrong with that.
We've got the speaker garden here.
Yeah.
It comes in pretty handy, I must say. So I said, this is the secret weapon. This is how I managed to get everything to sound great. And also coming out with the album, we're doing a digital EP featuring remixes by System 7, Mirror System, Seb Taylor, and Zen Lemonade. And this is the backyard to my little house in Bali, and this is my studio here, and that's Cozzy's studio there, got his and hers. And this is a coconut that's been gnawed by a squirrel.